Hi, everyone, and welcome. I'm joined today by Chris Hoder of the Azure AI product team, and he's here to show us something exciting. Chris, thanks for joining, and tell me a little bit about what you're here to introduce.
Yeah, thank you for having me. I'm really excited to talk about our latest reasoning model in the Azure OpenAI service, the o4-mini model. So what makes the o4-mini model special and new is it advances the next series of capabilities within the reasoning series. And so we're now adding in multimodal and the ability to reason and understand the images. And that just unlocks, you know, a whole set of data and use cases and capabilities. Also, as a mini series model, you get the speed and the price performance that you expect in the mini series. And those three things combined really mean that it's a great fit for real world enterprise scenarios that need, you know, quality performance at speed.
Amazing. So it's not just a faster, cheaper model. It actually has a lot more capabilities. Like you said, it's understanding images and text and doing deep reasoning.
Yeah,
exactly. Now, I work in the sales organization and I have a practical example. So actually, you know, a customer is a sales analyst and they often get asked by their executives, you know, they have dashboards and the executive wants to know what's going to happen if I change, say, my forecast, drop it by 20%. Actually, I have a dashboard example here and I need to do a quick analysis and these dashboards are complicated. Is this the type of thing that would be applicable for this model?
Yeah, this is a great example because you're going to ask text questions about the data. And that data can come from, say, just taking a simple screenshot of your dashboard. And so let me show you how this could work. We have your regional sales dashboard here,
right,
which is showing, you know, different sales information. But maybe, you know, for me, maybe I first time I'm seeing it, I don't necessarily know what all these data means. What I can do is just take a quick, simple screenshot.
Okay.
So this is just the current state.
Okay.
And then we can start to ask questions about it. And then I'm going to go into Azure AI Foundry and drop that into our playground just to show you how this works without getting into code. Mm-hmm. I'm going to drop this screenshot and then I'm going to take another screenshot showing this hypothetical 20% drop in our sales forecast. So maybe the business isn't doing so well. And then you could imagine that maybe the executive is going to the South, wants to understand what's happening, particularly in the US South. And so we're going to filter down on that area and take another screenshot.
And I notice here that, you know, there's a map there that looks a little complicated. Like, I mean, there's no legend to it. I have no idea what the colors mean. I mean, I can kind of guess where the states are, but that seems, you know, hard to interpret as well.
Yeah, I don't quite know what that means. It's also the only thing that has something about states in it. And so we'll see how the model is able to interpret that.
Great.
Let's hop into the Azure AI Foundry. I'm going to drop both of those screenshots on and ask it a question and learn more about what's happening. So I'm going to post both images. And I'm going to give it a simple prompt around compare the two dashboards, summarize the key impacts. Let's send this to the o4-mini model. And the reasoning models are going to basically look at all the models, spend some time analyzing and understanding what the image is and what the text is saying, and coming back with a reasoned argument. So it'll take a little bit longer than, say, the 4.0 or 4.0 mini models.
That's right.
But you'll find you'll get a kind of more thought through, more accurate information at the end.
Because it's syncing through it much more effectively.
Yeah.
Got it. Okay. Oh, I see some things coming back here.
Yeah. And so you can see now it's starting to stream out the response. And it's provided us a fairly lengthy summary off our simple prompt and two images. So I'm not going to go through the whole information, but just to show you some highlights of the insights and inferences it's able to make. You know, we asked it a fairly general question around how the impact with the 20% sales drop focusing on the southern region. And so it is able to do things like figure out which states, like Texas, you know, had the lion's share. It sheds almost 0.8 million. That is, you know, combining multiple different things. It's comparing the two different pictures. It's reasoning about the states. And if we go back to this dashboard, the states themselves are not mentioned. Where the states come out is this ambiguous heat map. And so it's understanding how to reason across that, make inferences about the images, but also compare multiple images together.
And I could see that being really useful. Like even you're saying, being able to extract the numbers from the charts and the graphs, being more effective. I know that we started to see that from some of the non-reasoning models, but being a bit more accurate and be able to really reason over what it's seeing, I could see that being really, really useful.
Yeah. And what we've been finding, right, is we've talked a lot over the years about unstructured text data and how much of it exists in the business world. There's, you know, a significant size of images as well, right? Whether it's pictures of dashboards, it's PowerPoint slides, it's PDFs that are image captures. And so, you know, we're finding this applies, you know, not just to business leaders. It can really apply anywhere. And so we're excited to see what people are going to build.
Yeah, this is really great. Now, Chris, I have another example. I know there's a lot of imagery and textual information in the medical space. Are there any use cases you saw that were particularly effective?
Yeah, that's another great example, because in healthcare, you have lots of imaging, you know, techniques, radiology in different areas. And then you also have your diagnostic notes, your text-based information. Yeah. And so to show that, we saw that Northwestern Medicine, its Department of Radiology, has a section on their website called Interesting Cases, where they highlight, you know, different patients that they've seen and what diagnosis they resulted in. And so just looking on this website here, we have a case from December 2024 where about a female patient who had progressive confusion. It's got both some patient history as well as images, presumably from an MRI. And this was December 2024. So this is after the training cutoff of the o4-mini. To show you the power of this, we're going to now show this within code. You know, if you were building this as an application, you'd be, you know, developing with it in code. And so jumping into VS Code in a notebook, we're going to just take the images and we're going to send them to the model and ask it for some diagnostic information.
Great.
All this notebook is really doing is taking those images that we've downloaded, you know, doing a little bit of pre-processing to convert them to Base64 and sending them to the service. And so I just have a pretty straightforward Python notebook here that I am calling the endpoints. I'm converting these images to Base64, and then I'm loading in these same images we saw on the website.
Yep.
And I'm running in a short prompt, basically providing that text-based history that we have and asking the model to provide its input on what's in the images and what the diagnosis might be. And so you'll see we sent it to the service and we got back this nice summary where it's finding information about what's in the imaging. So we have both the findings that it's extracting from those images, you know, looking at different things that are happening, as well as its diagnosis of acute toxic leukoencephalopathy, which if we go back to the website, you'll see is exactly what this case ended up being. And so in this case, it's accurate. I don't show this both to say, hey, it could become a diagnostic engine, but they're getting really good at interpreting that image and text capabilities, and it provides opportunities for new avenues to, for doctors, patients, and researchers to be more effective and efficient at their work.
Yeah, I love that because that's just a perfect example where there's just so much textual information, image, multimodal information, and to be able to really understand what it's seeing. Like I'm looking at these MRIs, I assume, and I have no idea what it means, but to be able to interpret and give medical professionals new avenues of diagnosis that they could investigate, I think is really powerful. But I'm curious, I assume a lot of industries have this multimodal information. Are you seeing any other examples where you see this being applicable?
Yeah, I think we see lots of areas where you can combine both image and text together. We talked about kind of maybe business executive world, interpreting dashboards, the medical world, you know, finance, insurance, and business, all of those have different areas of images and text. So for finance, it might be earnings reports or different PDF-based images. Insurance, you have, you know, the classic example is like an insurance claim. You take a picture of a car and you fill out a form. You know, now you can both understand the form, match the image, and start to automate those tasks as well.
I know one area that Microsoft really tries to make a strong effort in the area of safety and compliance. Is there anything in that space regarding this model that you would like to share with us?
Yeah, and it's spot on. You know, within the Azure AI team, we think about responsible use of these models like day in and day out. And that's everything from the tooling and observability to use and manage them effectively, but also in the model and ensuring that it's trained and it responds in a safe way. And so the o4-mini model continues that journey. It provides some significant improvements in safety and built-in capabilities to ensure that it is staying on track to the prompt and responding in a responsible way.
Wow, Chris, this is great. I can already see so many use cases where deep reasoning over text and images has such a strong applicability. I just wanted to thank you so much for joining us and explaining this. Makes way more sense to me. Is there anything you'd like to share before I let you go?
Yeah, thank you for having me. I firmly believe we're just scratching the surface of what's possible and what can be done with these models. And so I'm super excited to see what our customers and what people are going to do as they take these and apply them into their domains and their industries and see what's possible.
Awesome. Thanks, Chris.
Yeah, thank you.